Well, Mandy, that gas leak has now been repaired, and all of the streets are reopened here near 9th and Locust, right here by this construction site behind me. But earlier today, it was a very different story, as fire officials say that that gas leak forced evacuations and road closures.
The alarms went off and I thought it was a joke. And then I said, oh, I'm Superwoman, I can come and help, and they won't let me.
On this Halloween in downtown St. Louis, although some workers were dressed in their costumes, having a little fun, as the gas leak unfolded and hundreds were evacuated, it was no joke.
They shut us all down. They made us go across the street, and they made us go down the street and around the corner.
We ran, so I just dropped everything, my keys and everything, to get on down and tell everybody they have to evacuate the store.
The gas leak all unfolded around noon. Spire Energy, formerly Liquid Gas, responded to the scene to stop the gas from flowing. Authorities heard a hissing sound from the area as the gas escaped, and those were evacuated could smell the gas.
Best case scenario for us is that the gas was escaping into the atmosphere. It may smell kind of bad and people might not like that, but if it's pooling in a basement or a lobby or a nearby building, the levels can build to a flammable and or explosive range. And that's a bad day for all members or all folks involved.
Captain Gary Mosby says dangerous levels of natural gas had not been found inside any buildings. Authorities advised people to avoid the area as workers fixed the problem. It took about an hour to get the leak under control, and we are told construction workers were using a backhoe in the 900 block of Locust near 9th Street when they ruptured a 2-inch high-pressure gas line.
We evacuated in the immediate block, the 900 block of Locust. Other buildings self-evacuated their people. Now, that presented some challenges in that you had a lot of people coming out, but you can't fault folks for being proactive.
Now, the residents in the area who had to be evacuated say it was a little bit of an inconvenience, but they say they would rather be safe than sorry. Live in downtown St. Louis, Kelly Hoskins, Fox 2 News.